The live-action Aladdin. Was it shining, shimmering, splendid, and brought a new fantastic point of view? Or was it just another cash grab by Disney? Let's find out. Aladdin, the live-action version. It was directed by Guy Ritchie, and it stars Will Smith as the genie, Mina Massoud as Aladdin, Naomi Scott as Jasmine, Princess Jasmine, and also Marwan Kenzari as Jafar. And first and foremost, I'm just gonna say this, the trailer did not do justice to what this film is. If you've seen the trailer, you might be familiar that, oh, Will Smith looks bad as a genie, it looks horrible, the trailer was not very pleasing whatsoever. In my opinion, this film was much better than what the trailer and the marketing team put it out to be. I was invested in this film right off the bat. I go into this film, didn't have a lot of expectations, and I left the film pleasantly surprised. I enjoy the performances, I like the music choice and how they cover the songs. The world building it sucked me right in, and Will Smith's genie actually worked for me. And let's just start with the world building first. They make us dive in into Agrabah right off the bat, and they did not pull back their punches. And as soon as you're absorbed into the world and you accept what the film as what it is, you're invested and you are absorbed in the world, you see what you like, and that's how I felt to it. I like the original Aladdin. It is not my favorite Disney film, but I do love it a lot. And Agrabah in the original film, I guess in animated form, it doesn't feel as lively as it could be. But in the live action form, it feels very lively. You feel it just looks great. The set pieces looks great. The people around it looks. It definitely feels real, and it definitely feels lively. That's probably the best way to say it. And the casting, I feel like, let's just get to the big blue genie. Lots of people doesn't like how Will Smith looked in the film. At first, you might think so like that, but as soon as he starts performing, and by the way, in case you guys don't know, there are going to be spoilers in here because you probably have seen the original Aladdin film, right? If you have not, what are you doing with your life? Go check that out. If that original Disney animated film is a classic, and you might be familiar with the song Friend Like Me, and Robin Williams' version is fantastic, and you have to accept the fact that this Will Smith's Aladdin is not going to try to pretend and try to mimic what Robin Williams' genie is. Will Smith is going to play his own version of the genie, and as soon as you accept that fact, I believe you will truly enjoy it, and that's what I did. As soon as Will Smith did A Friend Like Me, that performance is probably one of my favorite throughout the whole film, and I really like Will Smith's take on the genie. And even in the human form that you have might seen in a trailer or in the picture or in photo of magazines, it really showcased he have charisma. Will Smith's known for having charisma in either on his real life or in films. He have charisma, and this Will Smith genie version really have charisma, and the performances really lives up. I like his take on it. I'm gonna go by song. Prince Ali, I like the Robin Williams version better. However, A Friend Like Me, the Will Smith version, I would say is just as good as Robin Williams version. You guys might hate me for that because, like, oh, how could you judge Robin Williams? This is my opinion. And I feel like Will Smith nailed it, and he nailed the character. And talking about the character in films, let's talk about Aladdin himself, Mina Massoud. How was he? I'm not familiar with Mina Massoud's work at all. I think he nails Aladdin. I would say it more humanizes Aladdin than the animated film. I haven't seen the animated film in a while, but I like Mina Massoud's portrayal of Aladdin in this film, the street rat, and I think he got the physical ability of Aladdin, as you might tell. What's the song? One Jump, the one in the very opening. that one's in the animated form, they really draw Aladdin to be like very flexible and everything. And with the help of Guy Ritchie's style, I think Mina Massoud nails it, the performance, the physical act, and Mina Massoud's vocal performance is great in this film. I like his performance as well. However, I would say the star, well, one of the biggest star in this film is Naomi Scott as Princess Jasmine. I would go as far as saying this is my favorite live-action portrayal of any Disney princess I've seen. I like it more than Lily James' Cinderella, and I like it more than Emma Watson's Belle. I believe those are the only two that we've seen in live-action. Well, you might count Elle Fanning in Maleficent, but this is definitely my favorite. I've followed Naomi Scott since her Lemonade Mouth days. That's a Disney Channel original movie, if you were familiar with that. You guys are awesome if you're familiar with that. And she performs. She have vocal performances in that film. And so I'm not surprised with what she can bring to the table in this film. There is a new song in this film, written only for this new film, not only the original film. And I think Naomi Scott nails that song. And yeah, I like a lot of the take that they did in most of their songs. And once again, once you suck into the world, you truly enjoy and get entertained. And in terms of entertainment, the choreography looks great. They did a lot of good job with the dance moves and with the set pieces and everything. And also the fighting was also interesting. There are some of them. And there are several new characters that are in this film that are not in the original film. And I think they add a new layer to some of the characters, which I like and truly enjoy. And of course, it's always hard to match the original the same way people are going to do comparisons with how Beauty and the Beast is comparison with the original. It's hard not to compare, and it's hard to live up, because Aladdin is considered one of the best Disney films, and so despite the fact that it doesn't live up to the original, I like this version a lot. Also, A Whole New World, their version of it, surprises me. And yeah, let's talk about Guy Ritchie and his style. Do I think it fits the film? Do I think it doesn't? There are two parts of this film that I do not particularly love or like, but I do not hate either. And this is Guy Ritchie's take on the film and his directing styles. You might be familiar with his styles. And also Jafar's performance by Marwan Kenzari. So let's get with Guy Ritchie's first. You might be familiar, usually he does like lots of slow-mo and like montages like that, and there are some scenes which with Guy Ritchie's style I feel like it works and it makes it look a bit cooler, I guess. But there are some scenes as well that they do slow-mo and those kind of stuff, and I was just shaking my head. I'm like, no, that doesn't really work, and I wish they didn't do that. But it doesn't really take me out of the movie. And also Jafar, this is definitely a different take. I'm not gonna say what it is. I don't think it's as menacing as the original Jafar. However, Marwan Kenzari did a good job. And I'm just gonna say I like the fact that this Jafar is a younger version of Jafar. Because in the original, you might know he's an older man. And I always find it creepy that Jafar likes Jasmine in the original film. Because I believe Jasmine's like only 13 in the animated film. I might be wrong. Correct me in the comment section. But I like the fact that this is younger, so it makes more sense and less creepy. And let's talk, I talk a lot about the pros in this film, in this review so far. Let's talk about the cons. Some of the CGI is a bit wonky. Some of the CGI looks alright, but some of them is, you can tell it's CGI and wonky. Abu and Iago looks great, in my opinion. Raja doesn't. Raja looks real fake to me, and maybe they're saving their budget for all the other stuff, maybe for the genie and for all the choreography, the set pieces, because there are a lot of CGI in this film. Even the background, some of the background look real, some of the background you can tell it's green screen. And maybe that's why they're saving the budget, because some of the lower CG, especially like Raja, it doesn't look real. It's a big step down from what they did with Shere Khan and in the Jungle Book. I don't know if they use the same team or not. Most likely they should be, because it's Disney, but who knows, it might be different. And I guess the best way to say another con in this film is that it doesn't have the same heart and the same charm as the original film does. Maybe it's because I'm familiar and I'm more attached with the original film, that when I see a new adaptation version of it, I'm like, that's not my Aladdin. And it's always tough. Like, if you do a comparison to a maybe recent one, Game of Thrones. If you're familiar with the source material and you see a film and the TV version, like, oh, that's not my Game of Thrones. Or if you see Marvel comics and you read the comics and you see the live action version, like, no, that's not my Marvel film. So it's always tough, especially you're gonna get comparison all the time. However, I'm just gonna say it, maybe because I'm familiar with the beats and the storylines, I see it coming. And it doesn't have enough charm and heart that the original one has. However, even though they have new stuff added, some stuff I like, some stuff it just lacks. That's probably the best way to say it. And yeah, a lot of the stuff I really like. It is surprisingly funny. There are lots of comedic beats that I thought they nailed it pretty well. And a lot of them has to do with Will Smith's genie, which is why I feel like if there are two positive things out of this film, it's Naomi Scott as Jasmine. I think Naomi Scott will become a star if she is not already a star already. I think, I said two. The main ones are Naomi Scott and Will Smith's genie. I think people will be surprised. I think people will like Will Smith's version of genie. And also another one, Mina Masood, I think is going to become a star. He looks like he's a pretty good guy, and I like his performance as Aladdin. So yeah. So overall, this film is visually amazing. The choreography is great. The music is great. The set pieces look great. I love all the performances from Mina Masood, from Naomi Scott, as I mentioned already, Will Smith, even Marwan Kenzari as Jafar. I wouldn't say I hate the performances. I like his take on it. And even though the execution might be lacking, because I'm familiar with the story, the execution might be lacking, it also lacks a bit of charm and a bit of heart. But I'm not saying it doesn't have charm and heart. It was there, it just wasn't the same as the animated form. However, I do really like it. And I like the fact, if this is gonna be someone's first time seeing Aladdin, if some kids out there are gonna be seeing Aladdin for the first time, and this is the version that they see, I wouldn't hate it, because they had a lot of good stuff going forward, and I feel like it will only bring more awareness to the animated version. So, once again, great set pieces, great world building, great performance, great music, great choreography, lacking a bit of the charm of the original. And with that, I'm just gonna give a score of 7.8 for Aladdin. Guys, what did you think of Aladdin? Have you seen it? Have you not seen it? Tell me if you do actually, if you've seen it, tell me if you like the animated form better or this version better in the comment section below. If you have not seen it, tell me what is your favorite song from Aladdin, and tell me if you like the animated version of Aladdin a lot or no. I want to hear it in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video and you would like to see the channel to grow, all you have to do is click the like button below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more movie reviews like this. Summer season is around the corner. Actually, it's actually already happening. So I'm going to be doing lots more movie reviews for you guys. I also do trailer reactions, Schmodown reactions. I have a podcast called The Councilman Podcast, which we upload movie-related contents daily. I also do all kinds of movie content. So subscribe if you don't want to miss out. And you can follow me on social media at Twitter and Instagram at JAVirudharma. Go check me out right there. You can engage me on Twitter. Tweet, all kinds of stuff, I'll definitely respond. So yeah guys, thank you for watching. Once again, share it with your friends, leave a like, it helped me out a lot, and subscribe. And until next time, ciao out.